Hey everybody, Chris with Up North Air Gunner. There's been a couple different topics I've wanted to cover, and I think today's video I'd like to knock a couple of those out. I get a lot of questions about my tethering setup. Not so much about how I tether to my rifle when I'm shooting for long distance or if I'm shooting off of the bench, but really how I'm using the tether to actually tune my gun. So I'm actually using the Huma External Regulator. And there's two different styles that are out there. One, you can actually get one where it's adjustable with a screwdriver within the valve. So here's the Huma External Regulator that doesn't have the external adjustments. This one actually has an internal adjustment where you use a screwdriver. So yeah, this one's kind of a set it and forget it type of model. And there's another one you can actually get from Europe where you can actually twist it and adjust the pressure on the fly. So when I'm tuning my gun, I'm actually using the Huma regulator that I can actually twist. So when you're zeroing your rifle, you can really dial it in, find that exact pressure, and remember that with that pressure, with that gun, and with that bullet, it's pretty much gonna be your go-to pressure. So your point of impact can actually change quite a bit, even at 100 PSI difference. And the reason why I shoot tethered like this is to get these shot groups as precise as possible. So I know when I'm gonna go hunting that that's the pressure I'm gonna fill at. So basically what I do is I set up a piece of cardboard, I put dots all over the cardboard. I try to take 5 shot groups at each one of those dots. Using various pressures, I typically start around 2300 PSI and work my way up to 3000 PSI. I try to move in about 200 PSI increments up, and I take the 5 shot groups. I see what kind of groupings I'm getting for each one of those pressures, and that's pretty much how I do it. It's pretty simple. I will say one thing I see a lot of guys doing when they're getting into this, sometimes they'll switch between ammo, different ammo weights, and they're all over the paper. So another thing I want to talk about today is, since I've told you a little bit about how I tune to a certain projectile, Nick Neilson from Neilson Specialty Ammo, Nick and I have been going back and forth for months. I was actually shooting a lot of his 180 grain bullets with my 357, and this right here is his new 350 grain boat tail. So this is one of the best slugs that I have shot through the Texan 45, hands down. I mean, the groups I'm getting at 50 yards were basically bullet on bullet, you know, maybe a 3/4 inch group. So earlier I was shooting these at 100 yards, just getting it dialed in. I mean, what I'm finding with this is this bullet between 2550 to 2650 is that sweet spot. And if I think if I can just dial this in a little bit more, I can get this down to a 1-inch group. So you guys know I like challenges. I shot the Nuthin Under 100 challenge from Gateway to Airguns GTA. I shot a 1.18 inch group with the 308, and that put me at the expert status, but my goal is to get master, so I really think I can get this down to a 1 inch group at 100 yards. Okay, so about 150 of these bullets later, almost went through 2 full tanks. So we were able to get that really good 5-shot group. You saw as I was tuning, once I got that dialed in, I literally have burned through probably 150, 175 of these. This is all I've got left of these. And my best target of the day, I'm not sure if it's master. I think I might be a little bit off. Yeah, but that's my best group of the day. I don't think I got master on that one. I think that's still just over 1 inch. I'm gonna have to put the calipers on it. It's close, guys. I'll have to see, but man, I mean, look at that. 100 yards with these Nick Neilson boat tails. I mean, these things are awesome. I mean, absolutely beautiful. I haven't done my full testing yet, but I believe the ballistic coefficient on these is significantly better than a flat base bullet. I don't have the numbers to back that up, but just based on my MOA settings at 100 yards versus other 350 grain ammo that I've shot before, I don't need to use as much elevation for these. So I'm guessing the BC is probably better on these. But man, I mean, that group, that is 5 dead deer right there. Thanks for joining me, everybody. I knocked a lot of information out today. I've been cooped up all winter long. Got a lot of video work I've been wanting to do. So today we were able to talk about how I tune my guns, how I use the Huma external regulator to do that, and then also the Nick Neilson specialty ammo. This is definitely, this is the magic pill, at least in my opinion. A lot of good ammo out there, but this is definitely one you need to try. So yep, I'll get home, I'll put the calipers on this target, see how we did. I think it's close, but anyway, that's probably one of my best five shot groups ever with the Texan. Anyway, thanks everybody for joining me. Chris with Up North Air Gunner.